What's good, y'all? Welcome back. In this video, we're going to talk about how to add or delete elements from a pre-existing matrix in MATLAB. Let's jump right in and take a look. Suppose that we define a matrix X, which is a row vector, negative 1 and 1. Let's suppose that we want to continue this type of trend by counting by powers of 2. Specifically, let's define the next part of this vector. In the first row, we're going to go to elements 3 and 4, and we're going to add 2 times the previous version of x. Notice x originally was a 1 by 2. This tells MATLAB, go to the end of the matrix x, add 2 more elements, which are 2 times the previous element in X. Let's do that one more time. So let's go add 4 more elements, 5, 2, 8, and we'll say, let's add 4 times this vector here. So now we've got negative 1, 1, negative 2, 2, negative 4, 4, negative 8, 8. We're kind of missing the 0 mark, so let's redefine X to include 0 and the previous version of X. This is now a 1 by 9. I would not recommend writing code like this in general. The point of this tutorial is to actually show you that when we do this type of work, it is super easy to reassign new values into a pre-existing matrix by just appending it. One thing to call out, notice that the size of this vector is a 1 by 9. Suppose that I went all the way over to the 20th entry and I defined that to be 1024, for example, MATLAB will automatically populate all the entries between the 9th and the 20th with zeros. Unless I specifically define other values for those, MATLAB will assume that my intention is to have all other entries to be zero. Notice how easy that was to add additional elements in my vector. Suppose I'm getting a little bit worried because I feel like I got carried away defining entries of this vector. What I can do here is let's go ahead and go from the 10th all the way to the 20th entry of this vector, and I'd like to tell MATLAB, please delete that for me. So this is called the null character. It takes everything from entry 10 to 20 and literally just gets rid of it. Poof, it disappears. Let's take a look at another example of how to add new entries to a vector. Let's define a variable count to 4 that goes from 1 all the way to 4. Then we'll define x to take count to 4 and then cube each individual entry of that. So now that's 1, 8, 27, 64. Suppose I wanted to keep that pattern going. So we'll call this count again, and we'll go from 5 all the way to 10. We'll call y count again, individual elements cubed. Now, if I define z, I could actually write z as x comma y. What we did there is we literally just appended the individual elements of x. At the end of that, take the individual elements of y. Let's take a look at a different way to achieve the same results. Let's clear our command window, and we'll also clear our memory by typing clear. In this case, we're going to go back to the previous command, count to 4, and then we'll define x to be the cubes of that. Next thing we'll do is we'll count again. So we'll go from 5 to 10. And then what we're going to do is we're actually going to take x equal to x and then count again and take the cubes of those numbers. This will overwrite the previous value of x by appending the new versions. Yet a third way to achieve the same values, let's go ahead and clear all of our memory. We'll clear our command window. Let's count to 4. And then we're going to cube those and set that equal to x. In this case, one of the ways that I could append those is actually just to say, go to x, this is row 1, we're going to go from 5 to 10, and I'd like to define that to be 5 to 10. We'll go ahead and write that in parentheses, and what we're going to do is to take the individual elements of that row vector and cube them. Notice I get the same vector that I had previously out again. These were all different ways that I could add elements to a pre-existing vector. If I wanted to delete some of those elements, let's say that I wanted to delete everything from row 3 to 10, all I do is say take the null vector there. That gets rid of everything in columns 3 through 10. We'll go ahead and clear the command prompt. We can do the same thing with matrices, of course. Let's go ahead and define a I6 to be the 6x6 identity matrix. Then what we're going to do is to define a new matrix Z, And in order to define Z, what we'll do is we'll take the first three columns of I6. So this is going to be every row, columns 1 through 3. For the fourth column, we'll go ahead and call this the ones vector, and it's going to be a 6 by 1. And then finally, we'll say that the last three columns of this matrix are going to take the last three columns of my 6 by 6 identity matrix. Notice that is columns 1, 2, and 3. Then I put all ones in. Then I go columns 4, 5, and 6. Suppose I wanted to get rid of the fourth column of this matrix. So if I go to the fourth column and then just hit it with the null operator, that deletes that one. I could do the same thing again. Let's get rid of the fourth column of my new matrix. That will get me down to columns 1, 2, 3, 5, and 6. I could also delete the second column of that matrix. Similarly, I could take the new matrix that results and deletes columns 1 through 2. Notice that each time I am slowly whittling down the individual columns, and the only thing that left in this case are columns 5 and 6. I could, of course, return Z to its original glory in a different form. Specifically, let's go ahead and define Z to be Z, and we'll go ahead and append on top of that a, let's call it a 6 by 4 identity matrix. So in this situation, we've actually permuted the individual columns by appending on the end of them the first 4 of the 6 by 6 identity basis vectors. Just as I could use the null operator to get rid of columns, I could also use the null operator to get rid of rows. Let's go ahead and annihilate the first 3 rows of this matrix by using our colon notation and the null operator appropriately. If we look at the resulting matrix that comes from annihilating the first 3 rows, suppose we're not so happy with the third and fourth column. This looks like it's going to be a 3 by 2. So one thing that we could do is go through all rows in columns 3 and 4. Let's go ahead and replace that with all 1 values. Notice that's a 3 by 2. Here, all those zeros turn to ones. I could, of course, go back into Z. Let's go ahead and look at these inner 2 ones right there. Let's take Z. Looks like it's going to be row 2, and this is going to be 3 through 4. And we will rewrite those to be -8 and 8. That is exactly what we've done here. Notice we are just slowly picking off individual elements. Did want to make one shout out. If I tried to annihilate a single element, let's call it element 2, 4. That's going to be this positive 8. Let's say that I told MATLAB, hey, get rid of that thing. MATLAB gets angry with me because I am not preserving the matrix structure. This matrix structure requires that I have all rows or all columns equally. I can't just eliminate one individual element. On the other hand, if I told MATLAB to annihilate the entire column 4, MATLAB would not complain because that actually preserves that larger matrix organization that we wanted to work with. In any situation, notice how easy it is to add new elements to existing array, delete columns, rows, or individual entries, and change the entries of a pre-existing matrix in memory just by using the appropriate call. That's exactly the point of this video. We'll get more practice using these in action later on in the course. Thanks so much for your attention. I'll see you in the next one.